Hi, this is Aisha, and today I will be talking about E.M. Chiodron's The Trouble with Being Born. Now, this is a very difficult book to talk about, even though it is not the most morbid and serious read of Chiodron's. The other book that I'm referring to is On the Heights of Despair. The Trouble with Being Born comes very close to the nihilistic groundwork of On the Heights of Despair. It is a good starting point for somebody who's not yet familiar and acquainted with his philosophy and way of writing. So when you compare it with On the Heights of Despair, this book is a very light and practical read. But only when you compare it with On the Heights of Despair. If you were to read The Trouble with Being Born as it, you know, by itself, you should know that the book has a lot of complex ideas and values that you may or may not agree with. It is 200 pages of aphorisms, you know, highlighting what it means exactly to be human and not to be. I feel like he has sketched a very lonely, melancholic and poetic landscape of human existence. He forces you to tighten the grip that's around most of us, I believe. You know, the grip of a strangled life, the isolation and emptiness of existence, and the fruitful nothingness of it all. Now, I know it sounds a bit contradictory when I say the fruitful nothingness of it all, as if emptiness somehow has more meaning and value than any kind of abundance, whether that's intellectual or emotional abundance. A good way to explain what I mean about fruitful nothingness is with Aristotle's Poetics. Now, in this book, Aristotle explains a catharsis as a deep emotional release that is brought upon by something outside of a human soul. It extends to this exteriority of life, of existence and of being. So the effects of a catharsis for a human being, you will feel it only after a storm passes. So in that light, the very common phrase, the calm before the storm, has more meaning and a sense behind it than we think. You know, the calm that happens, that takes place before a tragedy, is somehow full of anticipation and unease. Whereas the calm that precedes is, you know, that is followed by a tragic event or a storm, metaphorical storm, is more comforting and reassuring. So just as how these are two polar opposites, you know, the feelings of calm can also be anticipation for some people, while for others it can be comforting and relieving. Much in that same manner, I feel like in The Trouble with Being Born, the catharsis, this deep, isolated, emotional event that takes place in most of our lives because of fears and regrets and miseries. Now, according to Chiodron, these stem from our fear of mediocrity. The emptiness of our inner life that we constantly keep adding to, you know, keep filling up, only because we want to delay our confrontation with that same emptiness. Now, according to Chiodron, everything that we do, including talent, is an obstacle to the inner life. So becoming something in order to succeed is a slippery slope because it deludes us into thinking that we are actually succeeding, when in fact we're merely just masking this itch to never have to come face to face with this dormant and coldly stoic inner life that we all possess. So I'm going to read one of my favorite passages from the book. Everything is without basis, without substance. And I never repeat it to myself without feeling something like happiness. Unfortunately, there are so many moments when I fail to repeat it to myself. There are only a few books that I have read that have deeply moved me and that have felt just right. Now, The Trouble with Being Born is one of those books. The theme of this book is it destroys the foundations of time. You know, whether this is time in relation to your past, to your present, to your future, and so on. What Chiodron does is he parades humanity in a shell, and only so that he can eventually and blatantly pierce each and every corner of that shell. He's not concerned with what is spilling out, just so as long as the reader is aware of the fruitful nothingness of it all. until you reach that state of consciousness from which the self is completely deprived and, as Chiron writes, evacuated. What's left at the end of it all is to despair the trouble with being born. It is to despair the trouble of having to preserve, to reclaim, and to endure the essence of you. Now, I can understand why such a book might seem depressing to a lot of people, but for me, and this is also while I was reading it, I felt a very deep release, you know, from this prolonged fatigue that I wasn't even aware of feeling until I started to read this book. So all my efforts of trying to identify myself with the world and all my efforts of trying to identify the world with myself completely vanished. Right now, in my life, I don't think I'm looking for any sign or any sort of epiphany that will somehow make my reality seem any less monotonous and eternal. In his own words, man has slaved to belief, passing from dogma to dogma, illusion to illusion, and has given very little time to doubts, short intervals between epics of blindness. These doubts, he writes, are not in fact doubts, they are simply pauses, moments of respite followed by the fatigue that is brought upon by faith of any kind.